The Bible says it's not by power, it's not by might, but by the Spirit of the living God. The race of life is not to the swift, those who can run. Neither is the battle of life for those who are strong. It is God that gives mercy and chances to all. Up again. Every one of them showing up shall be put to shame. They shall be put to shame. They shall be put to shame.
Self-perception in grace. Self-perception in grace. There are things God wants you to take note of concerning yourself and the life you are living. You don't jump into using any product without the instruction of the manufacturer. The instruction of the manufacturer, which is called manual, gives you the guide to the usage and the access to the total delivery of the product if you can carefully follow it. Even at the level of human knowledge, there are maps, there are directions, there are things that you can't use well or benefit from until you have an idea of them or of it. So God says, there are a lot I need to let man know about himself and his environment. And I'm speaking to him, he's not understanding me, he's not hearing me. He said, I speak to him once, I speak twice, I speak to him in his sleep, I speak to him in vision. He can't catch it up. So I've jumped now into looking for a man who will stand as an interpreter of what I'm saying. Job 33, verse 14 and 15, and then from verse 23. God speaketh. Once, yea, twice, yet man perceived it not. Look at verse 15. In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falleth upon men, in slumbering upon the bed, God is talking, wants to show you something. He said, they can't catch it. Look at verse 23, from verse 23 now. If there be a messenger with him, an interpreter of what God says, one among a thousand. Now, this is the emphasis. To show unto man his uprightness. So, there are upright issues about your life that must be shown to you. There are things concerning you that have to be shown to you. So, you look at it. Verse 24 or 26, 24. Then he is gracious unto him and said, deliver him from going down to the pit. I have found a ransom. The next verse. His flesh shall be fresher than a child's. He shall return to the days of his youth. Say amen.
Amen.
26. He shall pray unto God and he will be favorable unto him after he has been shown what is his composition. After he has been shown what is his structure. Then he will begin to take delivery. Say with me, take delivery. Look at verse 26 there. And what again? And he shall see his face with joy. You have entered that realm. For he will render unto man his what? His righteousness. There is a lot God wants to release if you can catch the picture of it. That's why he told Jeremiah, hey, before you were formed in the womb of your mother, I knew you. I had a plan for your life, but I'm waiting for something. Can you catch it? Can you see it? If you can see it, I'll deliver it. Jeremiah 1 from verse 11, he said, what seest thou? And there he made us see something. In verse 11, he said, "What seest thou?" And Jeremiah said, "Behold, I see the rod of an almond tree." And God said, "That's correct. I will hasten to perform my word that you have seen. The blessings will come." Then in verse 13, he said, "Jeremiah, again, what are you seeing?" And Jeremiah said, "I can see that on the side of the north there is teething pot." And he said, "Trouble will come from there. If you see trouble, trouble comes. If you see good, good comes." Can I tell you something? If you don't change your focus, you can't change your encounter. We're just laying the foundation. See how far we can go on speed. In this new life, we have to labor for Christ to be built, to be established in us. And once that is done, you are no longer your former self. Philippians chapter 4, verse 9, there the scripture says, we have to labor until Christ be established in us. You labor until who is established? Christ is established in you. Christ will be established in you. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. You need to have an idea of who you are. A few days ago, we were trying to look at this subject from an angle. And we said that the devil is an enemy, roaring like a lion. But he is not one. You need to know that. He is not. He roars like a lion. But he is not a lion. And I was flashing something. We have that in 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8 and 9. But we have something also clear. In Revelation chapter 5, verse 5, the Bible says, the lion of the tribe of Judah, talking about Jesus. So one is like a lion. One is the lion. One is like a lion. The other is the lion. The lion of the tribe of Judah has prevailed. So lions of the tribe of Judah used to prevail. I'm going somewhere. And then he says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Philippians 2 and verse 5. That means carry what he carries. That means what? Carry what he carries. Carry what he carries. He had a very good... Jesus had a very good perception of himself. One day he will appear and say, I'm the bread of life. As they will be having a problem with that, he will say, I am my father, I want. And then as they will be having a problem with that, he will say, anybody's sin that I forgive is forgiven. As they are still having a problem with that, he will tell them, I came down from my father. And then when they got angry, he said, okay, destroy this temple. In 3 days, I'll bring it up again. He had a very good understanding of himself. I'm not comfortable with people who permits every environment, every atmosphere, every issue. For example, if you tell me anybody can die anyhow, and I try to correct you and you repeat it, you either leave or I'll leave. Because life has to do with self-understanding. You are aware that by reason of the righteousness that we have in Christ, we also carry the nature of the lion of the tribe of Judah. The righteous is as bold as a lion. And the lion is such a beast that does not turn back from any other beast. And I remember sharing with you, I'm laying the foundation, sharing with you that the secret of the lion's dominion over other animals is self-perception. The lion does not see itself as a victim in the hand of any other animal. I told you sometimes ago I was watching wildlife and one giraffe was passing by. The lion had not even killed the giraffe. It was already licking the mouth. Because as far as the lion is concerned, the giraffe is food. So the lion sees every other animal as meat, as food. So when it goes after them, it goes after them to eat. The lion concludes from the heart that as I'm going after this animal, I will kill and eat. That is what you are sent to do. Handle and win. Pursue and accomplish. In the name of Jesus Christ. So you can see it's all a subject of perception. 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 Who tells you that you can die anyhow? Somebody came to see me some years ago and said, man of God, they saw vision for me. They say the enemies have started again. They have gathered, they have started again. I began to laugh. I said, are you a Christian? Yes, born again. Do you read your Bible? He said, man of God, this is not a matter of laughing. I said, what you are saying is not new if you know what you are and what the world is. Have you not heard that surely the enemies shall gather together? Did he even say maybe? So what is the big revelation in saying they have gathered? That's their work. Your own is when they gather, they scatter. That's the side you are. That's the side you are. And you have such a heritage in Christ that is so clear. He said, I've given unto you power to tread upon serpent and upon scorpion and upon all the powers of the enemies. And by no means shall anything hurt you. Now you are faced with being interested in the release and taking delivery of it. One thing about what God offers is that it has to be accepted. What God gives is an offer. For it to be valid, there must be acceptance. Accept it. Have you not even heard that he said, when the enemy shall rise like a flood, the spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him? So the issue is not they may rise. When they rise, the spirit will rise. Isaiah 59 and verse 19. So don't be carried away by who is rising. For the purpose of getting the cables connected so that the voltage can circulate, remember that as long as you live, there will be challenges. There will be battles. Don't say, why me? The only time you are left alone is when you are not heading for anything good. If you will still become better, be ready to fight. It says, there is no temptation that has befallen you that is not common to all men. You will never encounter something somebody have never encountered. But the promise is that inside the same temptation, he will make a way for you. The temptation, the challenge, that word temptation is a compound word. The confrontation of what shouldn't be. The confrontation of something that, if allowed, could cause harm. It's common. That is why in Christianity, we don't start running here and there because there's a challenge. We concentrate and we overcome. Say amen to it.
Amen.
Say another amen to it.
Amen.
Just by the purpose of flashing it. The devil is the principal enemy. Say yes. Satan is the principal enemy. Our adversary, the devil. 1 Peter 5 from verse 8. Our adversary, the devil. So the arch enemy is the devil. But he manifests in various forms. When God begins to do some good things around us, he wants to plant his own into it. Matthew 13, verse 25 and 28. An enemy has done this. Satan has done this. So get it clear. Anytime you are in for something good, watch out for the finger of the devil. So you can put him where he belongs. Remember, he says, resist the devil and don't give him any place. Don't give him any place. Take up your birthright in Christ and say no to the devil that is after your destiny. We fight to win. We don't stay in pity to win. We fight to do what? To win. We fight to do what? To win. And there are other channels through which he comes up. He takes advantage of ignorance. When you don't know what you are supposed to know, he hides in it to trouble your life. Isaiah 5 and verse 13, that is there clearly. Also, he uses people who are very close to you, especially your own people. A man's enemy are of his own household. A man's foes, enemies are of his own household. Matthew 10 and verse 36. Matthew 10 and verse 36. And then he uses the hatred and the envy of people. Hatred and envy. Nehemiah chapter 4 and verse 1. When the Sambalat and the Tobiah saw that the Jews were coming up again, hatred and envy made them become enemies. And I have laid emphasis on that. Please take it clear. Never be brought to a point of believing that everybody wants you to do well. That's an error. Love everybody unconditionally, but don't believe everybody. The scripture says that even Jesus did miracles. Some people started following him, but he refused to believe every one of them. John chapter 2, verse 23 to 25. There are people who are carried up away by envy concerning your life. Love them, pray for them, but don't believe all of them. So envy can be a problem. Envy can be what? A problem. You will escape it.
Amen.
Sin can also be a problem. Hosea chapter 8 verse 3. Hosea 8 verse 3. Sin can also be a problem. Satan can take advantage of it and come after you. Look at what he says. Even God gets angry at it. Hosea 8 verse 3. Can we see it? Israel hath what? Cast off the thing that is good, the enemy shall pursue him. God forbid. When you abandon what pleases God, you become a candidate of enemy's pursuit. But he says, who is he that shall harm you if you are a follower of those things that are good? 1 Peter chapter 3 and verse 13. If you go after what pleases God, he gives you supernatural immunity. Now, we'll still be mentioning some of them in the course of time, but so we can take delivery, let's move forward. We need to understand who we are and pattern the unfolding of grace so that our spiritual mentality can exercise dominion over human limitations. We're going somewhere. I have seen clearly that God likens us to two principal animals, if you like, an animal and a bird, lion and eagle. That is what God likens his children to, lion and eagle. We have looked at a part of that of lion, but I want you to consider yourself as an eagle, and I'll give you the reasons. And I'm talking of us. I was studying the scriptures and God was talking about Moses, whom he used to do great miracles, using one man to bring out millions of people from captivity with all manner of miracles happening. And then he told Israel, I brought you out of captivity on the wings of an eagle. Moses was the eagle. Exodus 19 and verse 4. Moses was used, and then he referred to Moses as the eagle. So I'm talking to an eagle. I say I'm talking to an eagle.
Amen.
You are that eagle.
Amen.
Remember, he says that he will renew our strength like that of the eagle. Isaiah 40 and verse 31. Hear what he says in 2 Samuel chapter 1 verse 23. 2 Samuel chapter 1 verse 23. 2 Samuel chapter 1 verse 23. Look at it. Saul and Jonathan were lovely, and what again? Pleasant in their lives, and in their death, they were not divided. They were what? Than what? They were stronger than what? Now, the eagle and the lion are spiritual subjects. And I would like to begin to unfold it. Let me tell you a few things about the life of an eagle that you are. Look for some materials to know who an eagle is. I want to mention some of the characteristics of an eagle so you can know who you are. Number one, the bird eagle does not keep company with other birds. Eagles fly only with eagles. So a child of God who will be victorious will be careful about the company he keeps or she keeps. If you see an eagle with any other bird, it must be an eagle. And then as I was searching, I laid down on some things. An eagle does not mingle with other birds because their nature is different. So if you want to keep winning, choose whom you fly with. If you fly with anyhow birds, it can affect the nature that you carry. Years ago, my father told us a story about a man who caught a parrot and began to raise the parrot with chicken in his house. And the parrot is actually known to be the king of the birds. A parrot's leg is not supposed to touch the ground. How many of you know that bird parrot? The moment the leg of a parrot touches sand, even if it is not on the ground, you put sand inside any paper or leaf, and the leg touches it, it can't fly again. So the man began to raise the parrot, and the parrot started eating with chicken on the dung hill, the bola everywhere. So a visitor came to the man's house who knew about the nature of a parrot. And then he told the owner of the house, you are raising a parrot with chicken. This is an abomination. The man said, the parrot is already used to it. It cannot go to it. And then that visitor said, I can make this parrot live. And the owner of the parrot said, it's not possible. The parrot is already used to the chicken and they live together as one. And the man said, okay, give me some time. And you know, parrot can hear. One of the mysteries of nature is that parrot, in a short time, can hear, understand, and speak any language. So he carried up the parrot and said, parrot, parrot, you are the king of the birds. Being with chicken is an abomination. Get ready to go. And the man said, parrot, be thinking of this. In a short time, I will come back again. So the man came back and spoke to the parrot. I said, parrot, I'm going to raise you up. Attempt to fly and see the glory that God has given you. And see how many fruits are waiting for you. And see that you are supposed to be reigning in the air and not on the ground. So from that time, the parrot stopped eating with the chicken, but it was still on the ground. And the man came another day and raised the parrot. The parrot flew for a short distance and came back. And the man came and said, parrot, have you seen your glory? Have you seen where you belong to? I'm going to raise you. Go and go forever. And then he raised the parrot. The parrot left forever. The parrot took the place where it belonged to. Hear me? You have been feeding with chicken. Fly and take your place. Get lifted! It begins with your self-mentality, your self-perception. Who told you that you can fail like every other person? Who told you you can die like every other person? Who told you life can be negative to you like every other person? Have you not heard that the portion of Jacob is different from that of others? Has he not said he will make a difference between those who serve him and those who don't serve him? Right now, change your mentality. Your passion is different from that of others. Eagles don't fly with other birds. The passion of eagles is different, or are different, if you like, from that of other birds. Number two, eagles fly high. Eagles fly what? Very high. There's a write-up by a pilot, that the pilot, while flying with a plane, saw a bird after the first heaven. A few days ago, I spoke to you about the three heavens. The first one is this cloud you are seeing. Beyond this cloud, a bird was seen. And when the pilot came close, the pilot discovered that it was an eagle. Only eagles can take abnormal heights. Eagles fly high. Your destiny is high. Can I tell you the truth? The high places are meant for you. Deuteronomy chapter 32 from verse 8. God said, I picked up Jacob from the wilderness where nothing was working. And then I was his only God. And I was the only one leading him around. And then he said, I taught Jacob on how to go about life. And then he began to suck oil from the rock. And he began to ride on the high places of the earth. God cannot be leading you and then you are still at the low level. Permit me to leave a prophecy with you. From this day, your place has changed. Hear this. If people are disturbing you too much, you are flying too low. Today this one says the sergeant water. Tomorrow they say your shoe. You have, when you get to the higher point, it's not everybody that comes there. People who are there are business-minded. When you get high to the place where God has put you, you will discover that those you meet there are not too many and they are focused. If you are moving around with people, you wear this shirt today, they say, where you go carry the money from? You buy coke, they say, don't start again. You are flying too low. Flying too low. Eagles will live wherever all these birds are. Eagles will live there and go high to where those birds cannot come to, and then they enjoy life. That's where you are. This day, in the name of Jesus, you are lifted from ordinary levels. It's working because the number one thing is that you see it, number two, you believe. And then the supernatural hand of God will begin to take you there. Because God is interested in taking you there. It's, thank you, Holy Spirit. Hear this. All the unnecessary disturbances you are going through, very soon you will see them again. I told of the story of a pilot. A passenger was served with alcohol in the plane. They said, drink. That passenger was a child of God. Drink this alcohol. He said, no, I don't drink. And then the hostesses were insisting, just take something. Say, no, I'm a child of God. They said, a child of God. So you drink, drink. And then the man of God said, give it to the pilot. Let the pilot drink. So when they told the pilot said, that's forbidden. How can I be flying an aeroplane and drink alcohol? I will mess up. And then the child of God said, if I also drink, I will mess up because I'm flying. I'm flying. Fly high. Number three, eagles have sharp vision. Sharp vision. They see from afar. I was studying a few days ago and I discovered that an eagle can detect a mouse 2.2 kilometers away. Mouse, like rat, bush rat. 2.2 kilometers, the eye of an eagle will spot a mouse and say, that's a mouse. Then from that distance, the eye of an eagle can see fish inside sea, inside river. As a child of God, you need to calculate before you advance. See. We need to know what we are looking for. Our destiny is driven by vision. Remember, your vision is the preview of your future. Try to see. Try to do what? To see. I went in search of our material and I got something. There are five principal questions we must ask ourselves and find answer to. Under that, question number one, who am I? That question of who am I is the question of identity. Identify yourself. Who are you? Because if you don't know who you are, you can allow yourself to be everybody. Know yourself. Identity. I'm a child of God. Identify yourself. Identify yourself. Know who you are. Do you know that if you don't know who you are, people will give you names. They will give you what you should be. Now, your name cannot be called Jonah and then you'll be answering when they call Jacob. They say, Jacob. They say, sir. They say, are you Jacob? They say, no, my name is Jonah. That's an abomination. What is making people turn to everything is that they don't know their identity. Even the way you dress can either prove whether you know yourself or you don't know yourself. The places you go can show whether you know yourself or you don't know yourself. Amen. Question number two, how I wish I would have time to drill into some of these things. Question number two, where am I from? Where am I from? You need to change your perception of thinking that you are from Kogi. You are from Ukulan. You are from where again? Birala. You are from Igalala. You are from there. You are not from there. You are from heaven. Because until you understand that, their portion will be your portion. Their gods will be your God. You must ensure that you change where you are coming from the natural realm to the spiritual realm, so your portion can change. The things meant for you are not the things from where you were born. They are the things from heaven. That is why the result your father never had, you can have. That is why the problem of your tribe cannot be your problem. And you are already aware, the economy of your people is not your economy. Number three, why am I here? Why am I on earth? Remember, where purpose is not known, abuse is inevitable. So, you must ask yourself, why am I here? Why am I on earth? Get it defined. Sometimes ago, I was talking with our pastors, and I told them that we need to be satisfied with what God has called us to be. Otherwise, right now as we are in the church, there are people who are working in aeroplane, and there are people who are working in NMPC. And all. You can't be every one of them. So if you're here as a pastor, you're saying, I wish I'm working in NMPC. I wish I'm working in Shell Company. You don't know yourself. Why am I here? You can't be everybody. You can only be you. Why am I here? That question will help you so much. If you are in the office, for example, just to bring it down to the low level, if you are in the office, you know you are in the office. You don't behave in the office as if you are on your bed at home. Am I right? And that question is the question of purpose. What is your purpose on earth? What is your purpose? In every place, at any time, find out, what is my reason for being here? Some years ago, I was telling my wife, I said, look, look, between me and you, we are doing marriage. What we are doing is what? Marriage. Purpose. We are doing what? Marriage. Why am I on earth? And the answer will be given from heaven. Number four, what can I do? That talks about potential. What is my ability? What enablement do I have? So you'll not be trying to do what every other person is doing. When you have your own natural endowment put in you for a unique result. What can I do? What is my potential? When you understand these things, your battles in life are made so simple. Because the truth is this, hear me. You are going to be your best in what you are created to do. In what you have the enablement to do. Several times people try to do what others are doing because others are doing it and it looks as if it's working for them. So today they are facing this and tomorrow they are facing the other one. But you need to know what God has put in you. What can I do? What can I do? I remember in those years in the village, there used to be a woman that used to sell food very close to us. When you eat her stew, rice and stew, if you have money, you would like to buy again. And then they used to say humorously that even if it is her hand, she dusts into the rice, it will be delicious. Can I tell the truth? Now, even if it's food you can cook well, God gave you. Because there are many people having all the ingredients. When they cook, it's a mess. What can I do? Everybody can barb, but there are barbers. So. What can I do? We had our guest minister sing. When he was singing like a singer. Am I right? There are people that will want to sing. If you give them microphone, is make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Hallelujah! And they are still, because they are not wired for it. But that you can't sing like him does not mean you are a waste. There's something unique about you. Something unique. Some years ago, we were counseling people on marriage. Some people came and I saw that we needed to help them put some things in order. And I said, why do you want to marry this young man? And the lady said, because I like him. I love him. I said, it's not enough. What do you like or love in him? Because if you don't spot anything in him, the day you spot anything in somebody else, you will think you married a mistake. And then we kept talking. Okay, young man, what of you? The young man said, I like her voice. I mean the lady. The young man said, I like her voice. The lady said eventually that he liked the fingernails of the boy. But that is it for them. Don't tell me you want to marry somebody you don't like anything about. Don't try that too. Amen. In case you didn't spot anything, when you go back home now, spot it. What next? Where am I going? The journey of destiny. So that you can take your time to reassess your journey of destiny. Where am I going? Until you know where you are going, you don't know when you have missed the road. I have missed the road is for people who know where they are going. I am on the road. I am on the way. It's for people who know where they are going. Where am I going in life? Where am I heading to? This lifestyle I'm putting on, where is it taking me to? This whole life I'm living, where is it taking me to? Some people who don't ask themselves this question live as if they will live forever. Even at the level of our small children, I told them the other day, I said this flesh and blood gets to a point that it gets wear out. Even if you feel that you are young inside, it gets to a point that it ages out. So as you are living, tell yourself, I need to hasten up because I don't have forever to be here. And you know some people don't like to hear that. They don't like to hear that no matter how long you live, one day you will depart. They don't like to hear. And that's the truth. If you like, paint yourself like flower. And at the end of the period here, you should be knowing now that eternity is waiting. So live as if you are going somewhere. Don't live your life as if there won't be any other time in here. Where am I going? Even when you have money and you spend and spend, you need to ask yourself, where am I going with my pocket? You know, humorously, I shared with you the other time. There are people that the moment they get money, the money drives them. When they say, Dr. Jonah, how are you? Are you around? Have you eaten today? What do you like to eat all the time? Chicken. Then I give you half chicken. And then, as he's sitting, he says, have you taken much? I know you can take four. Take five. Until when the money for the come, he say, the enemy has come. Satan, I bind you. You don't know where you are going with your pocket. Where am I going? Let me flash some of the identities of an eagle that you are. I last told you that an eagle has high vision. High what? Then, number four is that an eagle approaches its prey with speed and precision. With what? Speed and what? Precision. When an eagle spots any prey, any animal that he wants to carry, even on land or in the sea, it will fly with speed straight to that point and pick it up. And that knocks off laziness from our life. You are not created to be lazy. When there is a target, shoot at it. When there is something you have to pursue, go after it! Procrastination, laziness, explanation shouldn't be there. What is to be done should be done. There is something I've discovered about the life of the realm of the spirit. It has timing. When you discover everybody is giving you attention, strike! When you discover some things, some doors are opening for you, enter them, walk on them, provided they are good doors. An eagle will take all the time to calculate. But once the calculation is done, the eagle strikes with precision and speed. It doesn't lazy around. Some people can be planning for 3 years. They have not started yet. I'm not saying time spent planning is a waste. But excessive and unnecessary time spent around is a waste. Eagles don't do that. Eagles don't do what? They don't do that. And then number five, eagles take advantage of storm. Storm. An eagle can sit down and be observing. The moment everywhere becomes boisterous, there is storm, the eagle enters into it. And then the storm will be carrying the eagle. Because it's known generally that eagles don't flap their wings too many times. Once they enter into the space, they spread their wings and they are there. As if there is a machine carrying them. They take advantage of troubles to move forward. You carry the nature of an eagle. Don't submit to storm. Fly in storm. We have divine nature that says that even if we pass through waters, we shall not be drowned. Fire, we shall not be burned. We pass through the valley of the shadow of death, the Lord will be with us. Don't surrender to storm. Take advantage of storm. Don't surrender to storm. Take advantage of what? Storm. Let me tell you the whole truth. Even if any storm of life appears to be pressing you hard, Number one, we have had, even in the course of the singing, the storm has time. It must expire. Under heaven, everything has time and season. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 and verse 1. Under heaven, everything has time and season. The storm must cease, but before it ceases, let the same storm take you to another level. Any storm that meets an eagle will not leave the eagle there. It will carry the eagle to somewhere. And the eagle will be so, the eagle will be flying with less stress. Lift up your right hand. May the troubles of your life move you forward. May the troubles of your life move you forward. In the name of Jesus Christ. Number 6, eagles make love in the air. They don't make love on the ground or on the tree. They do their mating in the air. Don't get united with people on the floor. In the air. I think time has come that we should open our hearts to people who have some experience, some encounter that can help us out. Don't relate with people unnecessarily on the floor. Eagles meet in the air. Now, that study reveals that before a female eagle will permit a male for the purpose of producing their young ones, they will first fight as if they are enemies. Because the female one wants to be sure that that male carries power. They don't want to have offsprings that are weaklings, or how do you call it? So they first go through some pressure, and then they turn it to relationship. They meet in the air. I pray in the name of Jesus that God will give you relationships that are up there. Where the strength and the energy is proved. Can I tell you the truth? Those who have not gone through the storm you have passed through to get to where you are cannot understand your pains. Let them fly and come up there so we can tell the same story. So when I'm saying I have a pinch, I have pain, they can know with me that that pain is understandable. There are people that when you try to tell them your life encounter and experience, they see it as mockery because they've not had that encounter. If you have not gone through my experience, how can you know my pain? My story will look like mockery to you if you have never encountered it. If you have not fallen and rising, you will laugh at me when I fall. If they have not made mockery of you and laughed at you, when they are laughing at me, you will call me another name. But if they have done it to you, when they are doing it to me, you will comfort me and tell me that there is hope after it. Let's meet up there. I'm not saying that it must be people who have aeroplane, but let it be people who can tell the story you are telling. If you have not known the pains that I have gone through in life, how can you understand the way I'm living? How can you understand my lifestyle if you don't understand my pains? How will you not make mockery of me if you have not faced what I'm facing? Why will you not call me names when you have not gone through what I'm going through? Don't even come and tell me that you have a testimony if you can't tell me how you got it. Because I am where I am by the grace of God. Anybody claiming to be responsible for where he is has no life experience. There are moments in life your certificate fails flat. Your human connection fails flat. Your strength fails flat. At that moment, the only one remaining is he that is above. So until you learn to hang on him, don't follow me. That's the way of an eagle. That is the way of what? An ego. That is how ego does it. That will not permit us. Eagles don't build their nest in low places. They build it high places. And the eagles also, when they discover that their feathers are getting weak, they themselves will remove the feather with all the pain and stay somewhere until they grow new ones. When you know you are weak, don't just continue to move around as if you are not yourself. Sit down and renew your strength. There's something I don't understand yet about some people. You know you don't have much of God. You know something is wrong and you are just jumping around. Some people can have time to tell stories and watch Nigerian film and they are dying spiritually. Some of them, they say, hey, by the time I finish watching the film by 2 a.m., when I wake up in the morning to pray, my body is weak. Your feathers are getting weak and you can't renew them. Some people can take permission to go for burial, but they can't stay in a day to attend to spiritual things. Some people can spend any time in the market, even without eating, but they don't know how to fast. Some people can move around for things that are irrelevant, but when it's time to come to church and renew their strength, even when the scripture says, those who come to Mount Zion move from strength to strength, they can't do that. And then they want grace to it. When the eagle discovers that the feathers are getting old, getting weak, it will settle down in a high place, use its own beak to remove the feathers, and stay there until another one grows, and when it is grown, the eagle will launch out again. Eagle, renew your strength. Eagle, renew your strength. Sometimes I tell myself, what's wrong with me? Today I'm not going out. Oh Lord, are you there? Show it to me. Now you are beginning to discover that nightmare, some negative things are happening. And you are still eating and drinking and laughing. And then the same people who are tormenting you are coming around you to check. You don't jump. You say you want to pray. Pray by this time. Make we go come. And you are agreeing. Eagles know when they are weak. And it takes time to build up again. I pray in the name of Jesus that before you return from this program, may your strength be renewed in the name of Jesus. May your strength be renewed in the name of Jesus. Your mental strength be renewed. Your financial strength be renewed. In the name of Jesus Christ. You know what he says? Isaiah 40 from verse 29. He says, even the youth, young people, can get weary. So God is not saying, never get weak. But he said, those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings. Things were working before, they are not working now, and you are jumping around. You are not even saying, what is it that has dried up my strength? I must renew it. I bear God witness, one little thing I've discovered in the journey of faith is that when you seek God, he visits you, he renews your strength. Your story can not only be, not that your story will just become like before, but it will be better than before. Your story will be better than before. I say your story will be better than before. Eagle, your story shall be better than before. Eagle, your story shall be better than before. Eagle, your story shall be renewed. Eagle, you will grow up new wings again. In the name of Jesus Christ. I've taken a lot of your time, but let me add this. Eagles don't fight dangerous enemies on the ground. They take them to the air. So when an eagle picks up a snake, it doesn't stay on the ground to fight a snake. It takes the snake into the air. And then while it's flying, it will be using the beak on the snake. And because until the snake's body touches the ground, it's not strong to fight, it becomes a victim to the evil. Take your battles to the realm of the spirit. Don't fight the enemies on the floor. Don't quarrel. And I mean, they talk like this. You know, God punish you. And then the person say, hey, me? God punish you. That is not where you are. The weapons of your warfare are not carnal. They are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Take it up there. Take it up there. Take it up. You will discover that until the enemy has what to hold, he can't defeat you. Say amen to it. So while the life of an eagle gives you the strategy for victory, the life of a lion gives you the heart for victory. Heart and strategy. The lion sees every other animal as a victim, as a prey, not as a warrior against the lion. I mentioned to you that the lion is not the tallest animal. So don't say, the man passed me. The nature God has put in you will win the battle. Say amen. Yeah. The lion is not even the physically strongest animal. The rhino is stronger. Rhino. But the lion uses mentality, the heart. The heart. The lion is not the fattest or the biggest animal. The elephant is there. But lions eat elephants. They kill it live and eat it. I've seen it. The lion is not the fastest animal, so don't say they are faster than me. The cheetah is faster. So don't measure your victory by the size of what is opposing you. Go after it with heart. Heart. I used to say when I'm spiritually drunk that whosoever is after me can't survive it. And I'm not talking more. Please, don't mistake confidence for pride. Confidence is not pride. Boldness is not pride. If I tell you can't kill me, well, must I agree that you can kill me? I say you can't kill me. They say that is pride. What type of pride? Okay. For me to be humble, I say, okay, you can kill me. Kill me. Is that humility? You can kill me. And I'm not making an empty boast. My trust is in the Lord. He's the fighter of my battles. His angels encompass round about me. And they deliver me from all my troubles. Psalm 34 and verse 7. The Lord will fight for me and I will hold my peace. God will fight for me and I will hold my peace. And he told me that evil shall slay the wicked. Those who hate the righteous shall be desolate. So you are after me, you are drying up. And I'm talking about every eagle here, every lion. If you allow God, it's a matter of time. In those days, I used to follow my father for hunting. He used to shoot birds in the air. When he is about to shoot any bird in the air, and he stands behind a tree and begins to do the calculation, he will tell me, be watching where it will land. So when he shoots, pow, he will be using his hand to follow the bird. And then where it lands in the bush, he will tell me, you see that tree there? Check the back of it. Calculation. I pray that you'll be delivered from anything that is making you see the negative side of yourself. You will make it all. The will of God for you shall be done. Amen. Can you get up and shake yourself, move your body and say, it is well with me. Declare that I'm free, I'm free, I'm going somewhere. At least even if you can't say it boldly when you are praying alone, be bold enough to say, anybody who is after me will be buried. We heard of somebody who was in Makurdi, living with neighbors who were into fetish things. And then he got born again. And he started doing warfare. In the night, he started saying, Lord, shoot arrows of fire against those who mention my name before idols. Shoot arrows of fire. Let fire. In the morning, the neighbors came and said, I beg, let us settle. Let us settle in this matter. Let us settle. I went to dedicate a shop for somebody in this town, and I came out in the daytime in the front of the shop pouring anointing oil down. He said, "Man of God, there are people outside." I said, "What do you mean?" Between anointing oil being poured in the front of your shop and their own sacrifice, and you do that, which one should be permitted? Make a boast of your God. You will not fail. Yeah. Get angry to a point of declaring that whatever God doesn't give me, I don't need it. What I need is what I have. What I don't have, I don't need. So that you won't be troubling, you say, you can as your prayer be answered. You see now, your prayer. Now. My God supplies my need, not my want. And he knows better than I know. What he has given me is what I need. What he has not given me yet, I don't need it yet. And in case anybody is sitting on your portion, God is saving his, you know, we have current account and savings. That one is entering into savings. Everyone under the influence of my voice, that Satan has given wrong mentality of him or herself, be delivered now in the name of Jesus. Every wrong mentality of yourself, your situation, your circumstance has given to you, disappear now in the name of Jesus. Disappear now in the name of Jesus. Disappear now in the name of Jesus. Romans 4 and verse 17, we have the God who can call on the things he cannot see as if he can see them. He's not seeing them physically, but he's calling them to come. In a few seconds, can you start calling what you are looking for? Call them to come. Call them to come. Lord, let my victory come. Let my peace come. Let my joy come. Thank you, blessed Father. In the name of Jesus Christ. Do I tell you the truth? Many people that were locked up, tied down, including those who started seeing danger, seeing death coming, are now set free. Can I hear you say, You are relieved. The journey can start again. A new dimension. A new dimension. A new dimension. A new dimension. Please turn to the person by your side and say, let's make it now. Let's make it. Let's make it. Let's make it. Let's make it. Let's move forward. God is dependable. God is reliable. If it were to be the words of Pastor Mada, I told you, you would have doubted. You would have been free to doubt. I spoke unto you the word of the Lord. That does not fail. It's not fair. I just had something. In the name of the Lord whom I preach to you, every resistance opposition is grounded in powder. It's grounded into powder. It's grounded into powder. It's grounded into powder. It's grounded into powder. I thought he will leave me till when I come for the prophetic session, but hear this. The scripture says you should not curse or bless your enemies. But the scripture is double-edged. The side that goes in depends on the need on the ground. Jesus went to a fig tree and wanted to have fruit from there. There was deception. And he said, you are cursed. But Jesus, you say we shouldn't curse. Then he said, the Son of Man is going as it is written of him. But woe unto whosoever is going through. Judas hanged himself. The apostles went to preach. Somebody was blocking them. And they said, you son of the devil. How long will you be an obstacle to the will of God? You shall be blind for a season. His eyes went off. Lift up your right hand. Whatever says you shouldn't be free is cursed. I declare them cursed in the name of Jesus. I declare them cursed in the name of Jesus. Whatever says your destiny will not flourish, I declare it cursed in the name of Jesus. I just heard the word, they say, how much more? And I saw it. How much more? And I saw it. Genesis 12, he said to Abraham, whosoever blesses you is blessed, but whosoever curses you is cursed. Those who are raising evil curses against you, they have multiple curses on them in the name of Jesus. Those cursing you are cursed. Those cursing your destiny are cursed. Those cursing your children are cursed. Those cursing your weapon are cursed. In the name of Jesus. Their escape is repentance. You know, this is a special service. Allow you to settle down so we can walk towards closing. Listen to this. The first step to take is to say, God, here I am. You can't have yourself to yourself and have God to you. Matthew 16. From verse 24. Matthew 16 from verse 24. He says, if you save your life, you lose it. But if you lose it, release it, then you have it. Look at it. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. And whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. Start from 24. Start from 24. Then said Jesus unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. You have to release your life to get it. Some of us are too careful to be released to God. Holding on to yourself and too many things. How will I live? How will I survive? Who will help me? Who will fight me? Because of that, you have not lost your... Some of you even went through battles and the situation has turned your mentality around. But God is saying, don't worry, release yourself to me first. If you release yourself to me, you have yourself back. Those of you here who would like to say, God, I've heard your word. Now, I believe in you more than ever before. I release myself to you. I would like to pray the first prayer here now with you. You lift up your hand. God, I'm releasing myself. I've heard your word. My confidence in you is stronger than before. I've made up my mind. Take me. Here I am. I want to release myself so I can gain myself back. Those of you with your hands up, come, let me pray with you quickly. Quickly. Keep clapping as they come. Keep clapping as they come. Keep clapping as they come. I am waiting for the last person. Keep coming. We are waiting for you. Keep coming. This place is free. Keep coming. Who is the pastor working with me? Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. They are coming. Keep clapping. From the overflow, we are waiting for you. Keep coming. 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 If you are coming, I'm still waiting for you. If you are coming, I'm still waiting. Some people are coming from the overflow. Is it? Keep coming. I'm hearing a ministration. If in your mind now there's a question going on, should I go? Do I go? Do I go or not? That is the way God speaks to people. That voice coming is telling you to come. So if there's any question in your mind, should I go? Should I join them? That question is telling you to come. Now come. I'm waiting for you. Join them. Come. Something is telling you, should I go? Should I go? That is how God talks. That is how God talks. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Win that battle going on in your mind and keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Should I go? Keep coming. If you are celebrating, celebrate properly. The angels in heaven are already celebrating. I perceive that somebody is still remaining who is saying, if I go, will I be able to make it? If I go, can I stand? You are not the one to make yourself stand. The part you are to play is the one you are playing now. The Holy Spirit will do the rest. So if you are there, especially you are saying, the other time I tried, can I be able to stand? Let me not go so that it will not look as if I went and I'm not doing it. I will still want you to come. God will do the rest. Let's come. Come. If I go, can I stand? Come. If I go, will I be able to stand? Come. Let's keep celebrating. Come. Come. We are waiting for you. We are waiting for you. Come. Keep coming. God will do the rest. You play your part. God will play the rest part. Come. 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 Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. I'll wait for you. Keep coming. I will wait for you. Keep coming. God is the one that will help you to stand. Those from the overflow, please make way for them. Don't let them pass through a long distance. They can come through any available. Let them keep coming. Let them keep coming. Let them keep coming. Let them keep coming. Now I want you to talk to God. I'm releasing myself to you. I'm sorry I stayed without you. I lived my life without you. I'm sorry for all my mistakes. I release myself to you now. I release myself to you, Almighty God. Let Jesus Christ reign on my over my life as my Lord and personal Savior. Forgive me my sins. Help me to live for you. Help me to fulfill your purpose. Deliver me from what I can't deliver myself from. Help my life. Please help my life. I'm sorry for all my mistakes. I didn't do it deliberately. I didn't do it deliberately. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. Have mercy on me. Give me new life. Give me new life. Lord Jesus, give me new life. Lord Jesus, give me new life. In Jesus' name. Lift up your hand to heaven and say this with belief. Lift up your hand. Almighty God, I am grateful that I'm still alive to see today. I'm grateful for your word that I have heard. I'm sorry for all my sins. I'm sorry for living without you as I suppose. Forgive me my sins. Cleanse me with your blood. Lord Jesus, I hand over my life to you. Be my Lord and my Savior. Give me new life and deliver me from Satan and all his works. I can't help myself. I need your help. Thank you for saving me. Thank you for giving me a new opportunity. My life is better. My name is written in the book of life. From now, things will turn in my favor to the glory of God in Jesus' name. Now close your eyes. Father, let the scripture be fulfilled. They have believed and they have spoken forth. Let salvation be given to them. I beg of you, O God, let the Holy Spirit go with them. Let their lives turn around for good. I pray you disconnect from them what they can't remove from themselves. Let the grip of Satan be loosed from their lives. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Congratulations to you all.